just a normal child. I cut his umbilical cord on his grandmother. He was a normal child. He was a little hyper when he was younger. As he grew older, he was just happy-go-lucky. Just loved life, loved people. He was born in Lansing, and he moved back to Phoenix. His mother was scared and disabled. And he stayed with her from the age of probably 2 to 6. And then he came back to me in Michigan, where I raised him. He came back here for a couple of months here recently, and to visit family. He was 20 years old. He was not on the couch playing video games. He was on the couch reading books. He was an avid reader. He didn't have children. He wasn't married.
He was someone who, you know how you have the childlike innocence of a child and you kind of grow out of it as an adult? He never lost that. That's why everyone comments on his smile. You can see it in everything that he does. He'll hold the door open for a random person. They're holding a styrofoam plate. He'll, do you need me to help you with that? Is everything okay? It's like he, his whole life is just wanting to be happy and wanting the world around him to be happy.
In fact, that's why he was chosen by the as a fundraiser because of his, sympathy for other people. He would always, if somebody was sad, he was always trying to say some encouraging words or do something to lift them up, and that led him to be publicly recognized, for his poetry and spoken word. He did a lot of volunteering. He volunteered with the age of videos for school hygiene, that type of thing. And he volunteered at homeless shelter, volunteered at daycare centers in Africa, substance abuse prevention. So he was constantly, most of the time volunteering. He was an avid reader. He loved anime. He was a marine explorer. The way that they approached the situation, they've demonized my grandson. This is who he is. Okay, this is my grandson. This, everyone knows him with the smile on his face. He was happy. He stopped to smell the flowers as we were walking down the street. He was a humanitarian. He was not the hardened criminal or fugitive that they made him out to be. The point is not what he has done in the past. This is a 20-year-old young man who has made a few mistakes in his life. Okay, we all have, but that's not the point. The point is that doesn't warrant a death sentence.